We want to solve the compound inequality and then express using interval notation. A compound inequality is two or more inequalities connected by the words and or or. Looking at the given inequality, it looks like we've combined two inequalities into one, and in this form, this represents two inequalities that have two conditions or two inequalities connected by and. Starting with the middle expression, we can read this in this direction from right to left. 2x minus 5 must be greater than negative 1. And we can also read this from left to right. So we'd have 2x minus 5 must also be less than or equal to 3. Looking at this first inequality, we could write this as negative 1 is less than 2x minus 5. But as you know, we like to have the variable on the left side. So we can change the order to read 2x minus 5 is greater than negative 1. And in red, we have 2x minus 5 is less than or equal to 3. Now we'll solve both of these inequalities for x, graph both intervals, then determine which interval would satisfy both inequalities at the same time. So here to solve for x, we'll add 5 to both sides. So we'd have 2x, this would be 0, is greater than negative 1 plus 5 is 4. Divide both sides by a positive 2. Now we're dividing by a positive, so we're not going to reverse the inequality. That's only when we divide or multiply it by a negative. So this would be 1x, or just x, greater than positive 2. Now let's go ahead and graph this interval. We have x is greater than 2, so notice how x cannot equal 2, so 2 is not in this interval. So we'll make an open point on 2, and then for greater than 2, that would be the numbers to the right. Now we'll go ahead and solve the red inequality. So again, we'll start by adding 5 to both sides of the inequality. This would be 0, so we have 2x. So less than or equal to 3 plus 5, that's 8. Now we divide both sides by 2. So we have x is less than or equal to 8 divided by 2 is equal to 4. Now 4 is in this interval because 4 is less than or equal to 4. So to show that 4 is in the interval, we make a closed point on 4. And then we'd have an arrow to the left for numbers less than 4. Now this is not the graph of our solution. We want all of the numbers that satisfy both inequalities at the same time, which means graphically we want the interval that's graphed both in blue and red. So you can see it would be the numbers between 2 and 4, not including 2, but including 4. Let's go ahead and clean this up. Again, our solution is the interval from 2 to 4, not including 2 and including 4. Which means for interval notation, we have the interval from 2 to 4. It's open on 2, so we use a rounded parenthesis. And it's closed on 4, so we use a square bracket. This indicates 4 is in the interval, and this indicates that 2 is not in the interval. And the last thing I want to mention is, we could rewrite this compound inequality in the form that was given to us, where the variable would be in the middle, and x is greater than 2, and less than or equal to positive 4. So we've now expressed the solution two ways using inequalities, graphically as well as in interval notation. I hope this was helpful.